Hallo?
Hi.
Hi. Dude, nice match. I saw the final rounds.
What then, man?
Troll despair.
Did you open the news?
No, not yet.
Open the news.
Okay, let's do
it. 2-team format. Clear path to pro and more.
Oof.
Okay, open the things.
Yeah. Here, zack. I have the block things open. Alright, guys, here we are. Trackmania Esports for 2023.
You read. You go first.
Okay. So, Trackmania World Tour, the whole thing is called. This is the official title of the Trackmania Grand League now. It's not really Trackmania Grand League anymore. It's Trackmania World Tour. Alright, let's read the first chapter. 4 months have gone by since the Trackmania...
Wait. Huh? You skipped something.
What did I...
Look at the logo, please. Yeah.
World Tour. And the Trackmania Grand League logo is the O and the O.
Exactly.
That's dank. Yeah, okay.
Cool. I had to, because that looks just...
Okay. 4 months have gone by since the Trackmania World Cup and the fifth world champion title for Carl Anthony, Carl Jr., Claudier. Yeah, dot. A few weeks after that, we shared that we were looking to rethink our plans and strategy for the upcoming years to put a strong emphasis on designing an esports for everyone and everywhere. Trackmania Esports will be revisited in 2023 with the introduction of the annual Trackmania World Tour, TMWT, and a brand new team format with 2v2 matches in every Trackmania World Tour League and related tournaments. What does that mean, Massa? We have, team format.
3 years of continuous learning and experience. Launched in 2019. Honestly, this is like whatever, but hey. The Trackmania Grand League has grown and evolved quite a lot since then. Those last years have been an amazing advantage we have built together and allowed us to set strong foundations for what's coming next. Yeah, we have always put a strong focus on creating the best competitive racing experience through innovative and powerful features. Okay, and next year will be no different. 2023 is going to be a year of major changes for the Trackmania competitive scene. That changing an ecosystem is not an easy task, and we approach it with great care. Okay, this feels like this part so far feels like just a press release, you know, to form some positive points. Our reflection began at the beginning of the previous Trackmania Grand League circuit, and our ideas have become clearer since the end of the World Cup, acknowledging that Trackmania Esports had to improve to determine a clear and consistent strategy for the upcoming years. Okay, what's next, Chronogame?
After multiple meetings with the different stakeholders of the Trackmania esports ecosystem and insightful discussions, we are delighted to present our largest and most ambitious expansion, the Trackmania World Tour! Wicked. The TMWT will be our annual esports circuit, which will include two already known leagues, the Trackmania Grand League and the Trackmania Challenger League, so basically that stays the same. Furthermore, brand new regional tournaments available for the four following regions, NCSA. Wait, what is NCSA?
North Carolina.
South Africa, okay. Then we have APEC.
<I'm>
So this term is only for APEC. Yeah, okay. And yeah. MEA, Middle East, Asia,
I guess? It's Asia, it's... Yeah. Nah, I think APEC is... no, but there's... Pacific? I don't know.
And Europe. With, of course, the annual Trackmania World Championship, which will be the conclusion of our competitive year. So Team TM World Cup is also still there. PogChamp. Alright.
Yeah. A new era. 2v2. Damn, this is so long.
Important.
Become the official esports format. While we will share more details about the Trackmania World Tour in the coming weeks and months, we know that everyone is eager to learn about the new format. For the past years, our esports has been designed around individual competitions and has included many different formats, from a pointless system to a fast-paced cup mode passing through multipliers. Yep. After various discussions with stakeholders, including players, I'm a stakeholder and a player. It was clear that a change was needed to improve the quality of life of our esports ecosystem and add another dimension to our competitions. Okay, keep on flexing. 2v2 team mode will be the new competitive standard in Trackmania starting 2023. Okay.
Good.
Every World Tour related event will be played with the brand new team format and with the exact same rules, game mode, and tracks. Well, what is it, Groningen?
Yeah, the format is... So now, actually, some more details on the format. Very important, because the format is very PogChamp, so you gotta listen, guys. So, the format is based on the classic team game mode with a point distribution rework. To win a track, a team must earn 10 points. Good to see that confirmed now, because we didn't even know about that yet.
Yeah, I didn't know.
Nope. Team must earn 10 points, and the points amount is subject to change before the beginning of the tour. Okay, so it's not confirmed. Alright. So, basically, the way it's gonna work. So we have 2v2, guys. And there are basically three scenarios of how a round can possibly end. It can be that one team, Team Pink here, could get first and second, while the other team gets third and fourth. That means Team Pink will gain 3 points, and the team that lost, 0 points. Then it can be 1-3 and 2-4. Then the team which gains, which was first and third, will get 2 points, and the team that will get second and fourth will get 1 point. And then, of course, there are two different draw situations, so either first and fourth, and second and third, or also... We have that situation, which will give each team 1 point. And the way it's basically going to work, like, you can get points in rounds, and as it says above, currently, per track, there are 10 points to gain. So the first team to gain 10 points onto a track with that point system that you can see in this picture here will win the map, which means there's no... it's not only about winning rounds anymore. There's no... it also already says it's going to be rounds mode, so no multi-lappers. That's already safe to say here. But that's really, really cool. That's probably the most competitive format we ever had in TMGL. Right?
Yes. Looks good, to be honest. Mm-hmm. This is what... Maybe you guys remember the memes with Omar and Tona versus XTD and Ambogos. I've shared this meme. Omar has presented this format to us with the... examples of Amogas and XTD as teammates.
Yep.
Yeah, obviously, that's a big question mark, right? Who's gonna play with who?
Yeah, that's of course the biggest question mark. Because first of all, like, for those of you that are really, really smart viewers here in our chats, you already see, since it's gonna be 2v2s, of course, also, does it say that anywhere? I mean, the conclusion of that is quite obvious.
We need to.
Does it say that?
No, that says rate. That says read the rest. New team format. We also want to strengthen the connection between the game and the competitive scene and provide a clear path to competitive pro play area for everyone. That's what I've been wanting since the new game. Let's see. We wish to streamline the process for players, all of skill levels who desire to grow in the competitive environment. One way of accomplishing this is to introduce competitive and relevant TMWT tracks, the highest ranks of ranked matchmaking.
Dude, they just said it so casually, man. They just said it so casually. Holy shit.
So casually, one line in here.
Yeah, dude, that's such a big change, man. Man, Trackmania.
So we can play TMWT maps in the ranked matchmaking.
Yes, so basically, matchmaking is gonna get TMGL maps, technically, or like... TMW.
And it looks like you collect points there or something.
As presented before,
the World Tour will also introduce various regional tournaments open to every player throughout the year with the goal of allowing up and coming regions to progress and have a chance to compete against the very best players in the world. The Trackmania World Championship. And there's the structure. You start all the way in the bottom. Looks like you can collect something there in matchmaking, then in regional tournaments, in Challenger, in Grand League, and then obviously you qualify for
the World Championship.
The World Cup.
Yeah, exactly. That's like basically the five ways of, like, the ladder of climbing up the Trackmania competitive scene, sort of. You can see that. But yeah, finally, this expansion will allow us to increase the uniformity of our leagues and competitions. We are excited to announce that every competitor playing in any Trackmania World Tour related tournament will now be playing on the same format, which means everyone will play those 2v2 formats apparently. They will be played in TMGL, they will be played in the Challenger League, and they will also be played in the regionals. They don't say something about matchmaking yet, so that's, I don't know, open, I don't know if that will change, no clue, like, we really don't know, I don't know. But maybe that will also change, maybe it will stay the same. Theoretically, yes. So maybe it will become 2v2. We will see.
Yeah.
But yeah, all players will also compete on the same tracks, but simplified versions of each track will be introduced alongside to ensure that we have an appropriate entry level to our competitive environment in matchmaking and regional tournaments. Details of these developments will follow at a later stage. But the way you can basically imagine, probably like the higher ranks, like the... What is it? Super... No, wait, how is the highest rank called? Grandmaster or something? Like the... Maybe the two...
I don't know.
Maybe the, so the highest ranks will probably play the regular TMGL maps, and then the lower it goes, the easier the versions of the map will become. So of course, a bronze player, which literally just started the game, is not able to complete regular TMGL maps, because they are really, really difficult. And so they will get easier versions, which is...
I'm pretty sure, as far as I know, if you're new to the game, you have to play first the campaign maps. And at some certain rank, I don't know what rank it will be, it's, there's no info.
Okay.
You will play TMGL maps.
Yeah, okay, that makes sense as well. That makes sense, I guess.
From a certain rank on. I think you need to be some certain rank. I don't know what rank it will be, but...
Okay.
Basically, it's all about stinking everything, and that's what I always wanted. And they have somehow listened. I have no idea how they listened to the
community. Yeah, they even asked us a lot of stuff and asked us for our opinions. Yep. Like, it was totally
pretty sick.
But impressive.
And let's be honest, at least from my chat-wise, people are draking and fogging, and I'm pretty sure this will make people play a lot more and get more connected with, such as TMGL Prac or whatever it will be called, TMGT Prac.
Definitely, I hope so. Because so far the player numbers in the Trackmania Open Grand League, which is not going to be a thing anymore apparently, but they always were super, super low. And with this, with the matchmaking and the regional tournaments, it will be a lot easier to get into it. Especially because matchmaking is free for everyone. So technically everyone can download the game and play the same maps, technically if they get really good, as the professional players do. And that's... was like the main goal, because that's how it is in other games as well. Like if you look at CSGO, for example, the people play the same maps there as the pros do. That's an important thing.
And the next thing, it actually says that there will be simplified versions of each track be introduced alongside to ensure that we have an appropriate entry level to our competitive environment in matchmaking and reach your tournament. So it looks like maybe if you're like silver or gold, you get easy or simplified TMGL maps, and then once you reach, you know, some of the highest ranks, you will only play the real maps,
and you will probably also have the chance to play against TMGL players then, because they will probably play matchmaking actively as well then, at least most, I guess.
Yeah, since it's part of the world tour, looks like we will be in matchmaking as well, so yeah, you can play against.
That's also a really nice goal, actually, for people that, like, if they achieve, if they just progress and progress in matchmaking, at the end, they are the end bosses.
They can test their skill, basically.
Exactly.
Against the highest in the game.
True, true.
All Trackmania World Tour related tournaments will credit players points according to results. So that's what it kind of meant. So everything that is in here, if you scroll a bit up, the World Championship, Grand League, Challenger, Regional, and Matchmaking will give you points. And then it will give you points to have a chance in securing a spot for the World Championship via the wildcard system at the end of the regular season circuit. Doesn't really say what the wildcard system is, but it says probably in the next one. The 8 teams that accumulate the most points in the World Tour ranking will qualify automatically to the World Championship, with the wildcard system providing additional slots for the team to qualify. The guarantee that each region, NCSA, APEC, and MEA will obtain slots, granted they have teams left. How many slots will still to be determined? So yeah, there will be guaranteed slots for regional players in the wildcard event of the World Cup, which is a second tournament before the World Cup, basically. And via that, you can qualify into the World Cup as well. And it looks like it's going to be 16 teams in the World Cup, so 32 players.
Which is
since 8 already qualify and 8 qualify again, so there's gonna be a massive new amount of players competing, and that can be anyone, maybe even you know,
yeah,
like you even... in Twitch chat if you type one,
yeah, exactly.
Stay tuned for No Mountains. Okay.
Yeah. Also, all remaining details about the World Tour shall be announced in November. So we have more announcements to come. Yeah, exactly. There's still a bit more to announce, and especially, of course, the question that you guys ask most about, like, who's gonna play with who? That's, of course, the most interesting thing. But, yeah, it's also, like, for us players, it's also not confirmed yet, not for anyone. So, we also don't know yet. It's not safe to say.
Official official information is, it's there is people are not allowed to, well, orcs are not allowed to talk to players at the moment. So we don't know. We literally don't know, actually. We also don't know which orcs are in. It doesn't say that, actually.
Yeah.
He said it's going to be announced that there will be something. Yeah, we need to wait. The eight teams. I don't know who the eight teams are in the Trackmania Grand Tour. Or no, what is called? Trackmania Grand League. Trackmania Grand League, sorry. Yeah. I don't know what the players are in TMGL, basically.
Yeah,
it's still called TMGL. Okay.
But that's of course also the interesting thing, like now that we switch to a duo format and each org is gonna have two players and the amount of players in Team GL or Team CL is of course not gonna double, like it's not like we're gonna have 32 players. We're gonna like basically half the amount of orcs and that's also gonna be pretty interesting. Yeah, but also there, like as Massa said, like we have no clue who's gonna make it or not. Not safe to say at least, so... Yeah.
Everyone will have a duo. We just don't know who plays with who yet.
Spam.
Obviously, you can guess who wants to play with who.
I mean, there are some obvious choices, but like, don't be too sure about stuff. Like as we said, like it's not set in stone yet. Also, at Spam, is set in stone yet. We don't know yet.
I don't think there's anyone sure. That's the thing. Like orcs need to say yes. Players need to say yes. Omar has to say yes.
Yeah, the most difficult part.
Oh, we don't know. We literally don't know. But it should be solved in the next few weeks, I think.
Yep. Oh, interesting question. Did the orcs actually agree on that? it's not really the orcs' choice. I mean, yes, kinda. But in the end, it was TMGL's choice. And I mean, there are orcs that will have to leave TMGL, obviously, because we're gonna cut from 16 to 8. So 8 will have to go. And... yeah, most of them would probably not be too happy about it, but that's just, of course, that's not the best thing, but it's just for the better. Also, maybe some...
People were confused about the format. Is your chat confused?
Is my chat confused?
Like how 2v2 is gonna work?
Guys, maybe type 1 if we have to explain that again.
Do we have to explain the format again?
I don't know
how it's gonna work.
I can maybe show the picture.
People ask in my chat, they don't understand 2v2. Is that still the thing? Is that still the case?
I don't know. My chat is just typing some numbers.
No, 2v2 looks good. Just how the orcs will work out. Okay, so you guys understand this. I mean, you can read it up yourself.
This picture should be safe to say. Like, just look at the picture again, and it's pretty self-explanatory. What's the question? How the orcs are gonna work, or what?
How the orcs are gonna work and how it will work in MM. Well, there's nothing in MM and we don't know either, so...
Yeah, I mean, as we said, like, it would make sense to switch to 2v2, because if that's supposed to be, like, the official, like, the Trackmania format, then it would make sense.
I mean,
but on
I would
the other
assume
hand...
it...
Hmm?
I would assume it's the same in matchmaking, just a random map, probably, and just points.
Yeah, one random map and then probably until 10 points and then you have the same format. That would make sense because this format, like, the usual issue you have with 2v2s is that there can be a lot of ties. But with this format... Yeah, exactly. But with this format here, where each team still gets 1 point, it's not that big of an issue because the match still progresses. So, I mean, this format would perfectly work for matchmaking as well. But as I said, like, we really don't know. I don't know.
So, you lock in your 2v2 team for the whole year, ? Well, I guess.
Probably, I mean, it would make sense.
There are more details, but they are not shared. The thing is, we know a bit more than this. Not much more, though, but like,
I mean,
know some details, like that, for example, but not what to say.
In the bottom, I think, you can collect points to qualify for the Trackmania World Championship throughout the whole year, like via matchmaking, regional tournaments, etc., and also via the Grand League and Challenger. So I don't know how it would work. How should it work when it was possible to switch a teammate in the middle of the year? Like, how would you still get a point because you only qualify as a duo? You don't qualify as solo player for the World Championship. I don't know how that would work. But I guess we will see. I don't know.
I guess you just collect points by yourself.
Yeah, possible.
I don't know, actually. I have no idea. No idea. We don't know. We just know that matchmaking will have the TMGL maps, quote unquote, and it will be implemented in order to qualify for the World Cup or other tournaments. And also other tournaments will be played on TMGL maps. So everything will be about map pack.
Exactly. So if the maps are good, it will be a huge change. But if the maps stay the same, the way they were previously, I don't know. We will see.
It also doesn't really say how many maps there will be. It doesn't say... there are so many details still missing.
Yeah.
As we said, there are a few more details we know,
but I don't know if we're allowed to tell, so we just...
I know how many maps to win. I know when... To win a match, a team will have to win a certain amount number of tracks, with best of seven being the standard. Okay, so it looks like we will have at least seven maps. Seven maps per match.
Yeah. I mean, seven maps is already quite a bit. So like, if you have the first match already, you already have to be prepared on seven maps, which is quite a lot, or at least seven.
Each Sunday, if it's still Sunday. You will have to be prepared. It also says here, the entirety of the circuit and its dates will be revealed in November. Okay, so next month, you're going to have the whole structure, the whole calendar, the whole everything, basically.
True.
And everything is set in stone.
Yep, we also don't have that yet. Same for the teams, especially. I mean, the teams and the players are going to be the main thing. I don't know when they will announce teams, though, or like the exact players. We will also see about that. I don't know.
Yep.
We will see. It also doesn't say how, like, who's going to play at all. Like, we don't even know.
Nope. Will the org count as the basis for the region, even if the players aren't from that region? Well, Ayagidi, that's a good question. We don't know. Well, we know potentially, but it's not confirmed. So it's only confirmed if there is an actual post in rulebook. Yes. Yeah. There are talks. They ask us as well. They inform us as well. Everything is fine. And this is now just the concept. Basically, you get delivered to the public, so people know it's gonna be 2v2. And I'm gonna be honest though, it would have been nice if they put a bit more details.
Yeah, they could have.
Since many details are a bit clear, yeah, like maybe like an extra page where you can read up about the details.
That would have been good, yeah.
Because now there's so many questions, like.
Yeah, true. But maybe they also want that. They want people to talk about it and to speculate or something. Like, especially with the players, and of course, there's going to be a lot of speculation. Like, Carl Jr. is going to play with Bren for sure. Then there is, I don't know, Mime playing
Clueless.
With. I don't know who could mind play with. I don't know, like, we also don't know, of course, as a players, because so far, as Massa said, orcs were not allowed to contact players officially. Some also did, because at some point, Softy was sending an ad at everyone saying that again. So probably there already were some talks here and there. But officially, it's not allowed yet, and officially, we also don't know anything. So that's gonna be pretty interesting.
Do orcs still hold the spots? I'm just gonna answer that question because as CBA, yes. Orcs hold the spot and they pick the players. That's how it's gonna work.
Yep.
I'm just gonna say that. I don't know. This is not so clear in this news post, but I'm just gonna say it because this whole question is just dumb.
Yep.
It's eight orcs, pick two players. But Big can just pick someone else if they want to. They can literally pick T-Dog 20.
Yep. Could also pick Carlin or that's the thing.
Yeah. That's how it's gonna work. So we don't know. Until we don't have contracts or whatever, there's nothing confirmed.
Yeah. The thing is, the contracts of most players, they run for exactly 1 year, and they will run out on the 31st of December. So it's exactly running 1 year.
Yeah, most players probably have till the end of this year, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, there are some that have already a longer contract, but I mean, that's just the standard. Also, because when the contracts were made, Trackmania is not the safest esport. It's not like it's safe to say Trackmania Grand League is still gonna be a thing in like 5 years, or at least 2 years ago, it wasn't safe to say that. Now it's at least safe that we're gonna have this for the next 2 years or so.
Nice league.
Hmm? Wait, didn't say that anymore.
No. Oh, there you have another league, guys. Yeah, that's what I mean, you know, like.
Yeah, they should have shared it, man. It's so bad because we know more than it says here, but.
It's not a big league, but they want to have this at least for 2 years. That's what we got told, at least.
Which doesn't mean, though, that we're also gonna. That the duels are gonna be kept for 2 years or something, like.
Yeah,
it only says the format.
We can also say that. You can switch players, just like in any other games. Like, the orcs own the spot. If you do some maths, the orc owns the spot, they can do whatever they want. So
if you play Giga shit, and then.
If they decide to kick a guy from their team, if I'm on big and decide to kick me, they can just kick me. Or bench me, quote unquote. You know how it works in these games.
Yup.
Take another guy.
Question my chat. So Nadeo has total control on what orcs can get a slot. Most likely. I don't know. We don't know what aspects are getting into consideration there. Like, that's nothing we as players have to know. So, but most likely, yes. I don't know if, like, maybe also new orcs can apply for it or something. We really don't know. Like, we are players.
We don't know. We actually don't know. Nobody knows if their orc is in Team GL. Officially,
yeah. Technically, like, not.
We actually, I think it's not even set yet, by the way. But we literally don't know which orc is in Team GL. It could literally be, I don't fucking know. G2 could have a spot, and we don't know.
Technically, like, yes.
We don't know. Orcs pay for spot? No idea. Don't think so, but no idea, man.
But I mean, most likely they will just pick orcs that will benefit the league the most, either in terms of in terms of followers or in terms of they contribute in another way. I mean, that would make sense. They will not, like, the small Kikega orc with 2,000 followers will probably be less likely to get a spot. That's quite obvious, I guess. So we will.
Can you pick any teammate or only teammates from the highest rank? I'm just gonna spoil it as well. You can pick anyone. I mean, we kind of said that already. You can pick anyone.
But not we can pick anyone. They can pick anyone because it's not like you guys. Yeah, exactly. So it's not like Massa's saying, "Oh yeah, I want to play with Carl Jr." and then Big is gonna try to get Carl Jr. That's not how it works. It's technically fully though. I mean, of course.
That's how it could work. Yeah.
Yeah, of course, of course. Like, of course, the good orcs are also gonna listen to the player and not just gonna be like, "Yo, you're gonna play with that guy there." But technically, it is the orc's choice.
In the end, the orc is deciding.
Wait, why should I remove music? Nah, I'm gonna keep the music.
So players that advance to Team GL will have to be picked up by one of the partner orcs. Well, it doesn't say that, and this is not confirmed either. But let's say someone loses relegation, and the orc should be out, I guess, or could be out, and then the orc that is in Challenger gets into Team GL. This is how I guess it will work, but not confirmed.
Yeah,
so we have to wait and see.
Yeah,
that would make sense. There's so many questions around this.
But that's also like that can also be a bit weird because, like, let's say I don't know, a big orc. Let's just say Solary has like a really bad season, and Solary is like one of the biggest orcs, and they get relegated, and then some Andy orc is gonna go up. I don't know if that's how it's gonna be working.
Maybe no idea.
So we will see, because that would not really benefit the league, of course, if, yeah, you know, makes sense. Or K-Corp, maybe. Like, if K-Corp would drop out, if they even play, like, we don't even know that. We're gonna see.
Yeah.
But, I don't know.
We don't know. Officially, we don't know. Like, we think it's gonna be like that, so the orc drops out and the other orc gets in. But, you know, like Rai just explained, if there is a rough case... Gonna be a really bad thing. Team to see 2v2 as well. Everything is 2v2 that you see on the
picture
below.
Yep.
Everything is 2v2. So also matchmaking will be 2v2.
Yeah. Also, like, maybe it's interesting some reasons why they picked 2v2. That's not really a spoiler. It's just what we got told. Like, and what also makes sense. First of all, I mean, 2v2s are successful in Trackmania. Like, the 2v2 Setter teacups, for example, were a success. And the good thing that comes with 2v2 is, at least that's how it is in my opinion, other players might see it different, but winning is more fun if you have a teammate, like if you win together, but also losing isn't as painful when you have a teammate, unless you completely suck and your teammate lost because of you, that's of course a bit bad then. But those were two of the reasons, mainly. And it's also, like, I don't know, it's just, for example, with the World Cup, that it has 16 teams then, aka 32 players, I think it makes it a little bit easier to get an entry into the competition than just as a solo player. But on the other hand, the format is of course also in a way, it's not like you can get carried. So it's not like Carl Jr. can pick some random Andy and then they're going to win Trackmania World Cup. That's not how it's going to work. Like, the team is, will only be as good as the best players, or like the worst players, kind of. So, yo.
Yep.
I got here late, what is the announcement? Or you better just read the article yourself again. I can post it in chat again. But the main changes are, of course, the duo mode, and I would also say, like, the matchmaking changes, they are pretty big, mainly. About the regional tournaments, we will have to see, because we literally don't know anything about them, except for the fact that they will exist. No idea how that is gonna work. I mean, of course, they will also have the 2v2 format, but other than that, no clue how that's gonna work. We will see. Maybe it's gonna be similar to the way, I mean, there already are regional tournaments hosted occasionally. Like, there's North America Cup and stuff, and then there's also the Baltic things. Maybe it's also gonna be similar to that. We'll see. Maybe you have to qualify for the spots. Maybe those will have offline finals or something. We will see. Would be cool. It also doesn't say anything about that, actually, if it will be offline finals or anything, but we also don't know that, sadly.
No idea. There are so many things missing.
Yeah. But I mean, having like the TMGL playoffs and the World Cup offline wouldn't hurt, definitely. So it would be cool to see that. But I guess that will also be announced in November then. I will see. And yes, the matchmaking changes are gonna start January. Probably with the new season, with winter 2023. That would make sense, I guess. So we will see. Are you teaming with Massa or just announcing together? We're just announcing together. Like, as we said, like, orcs, we're not allowed to contact players yet, and nothing is set in stone. So we will see.
I'm not playing with him, guys. Like, this guy has a wheel on LAN.
Yeah.
Don't remember?
Yeah. Massa already sat next to me twice, and he always was annoyed by me. How is that supposed to work?
Not gonna team up with him.
Yeah. You should play with Mime, because Mime is always super calm, no matter what happens. There could be a tornado around him, and he would sit there and be like Giga Chat with his keyboard.
Nah, I like the whole team format. I like everything about it. I like everything about this. The only thing I dislike about this news is there's too little news.
Yeah,
there's
true.
So many fucking questions.
True.
And I don't know what I'm allowed to answer and what not.
I mean, the most controversial thing might become the map still. Depends on how they will, if they will work on that. That's going to be interesting. But yeah, we haven't seen a single map yet. I don't know if they even started mapping yet. We will see. It's not even safe yet when the TMGL is going to start. I mean, yeah, somewhere next year, obviously, because that's where the World Tour starts. But when exactly, we will see. The Grenady Scrappy Dream Team is still possible. I mean, technically it could work. Like, literally any team could be possible, because orcs have choice. That's the thing. There could also be like someone completely random. I don't know. So we will see.
It could be that there is gonna be some NA orc that is coming in, like Liquid. I don't know. Well, Liquid is not. Well, Liquid is also okay.
Is it NA or like, yeah?
Take any NA orc. I don't fucking know. It's, take whatever orc. NA orc. Biggest NA orcs coming in, and they want NA players, and they just pick two NA players.
Could be possible. Like, even if they just want them for like marketing purposes or something, or whatever. I mean, it wouldn't be the smartest thing, but
yes.
We'll see.
T9 also has 5 Russian players in CS:GO.
Yeah. Or Shaky Dursing. So the 16 TMGL players are not set. I mean, since they're allowed to pick anyone, no. That's could also, I mean, it would be smart to pick most of them from there, because those are the players that, you know, like, have shown themselves, and that they showed that they are worthy, to say it that way. But technically,
since you don't want to lose a spot either, you want the best players as well, right?
Yeah, of course. It would make sense, but I mean, there are also good players in Challenger. So,
yeah,
we will see.
That's true. I can definitely see someone like Binks get picked.
Yeah.
It's probably the biggest name.
Yeah, Binks.
In Challenger right now.
Yeah, in Challenger, I don't know who even else plays in Challenger. I don't know. There's people like Barbos, for example.
Or Scrappy or Spam getting picked.
I mean,
if, you know,
Spam
for the exposure, and he's good as well, of course. Yeah. Same with spam.
True. Technically. Could be easy. Or Elkon as well, for example. Like Elkon.
Yeah, or really Elkon, yeah. Like, Elkon, yeah.
Possible. So we'll see about that.
ITB gets a spot, they're getting Elkon up for sure with mine. Well, I don't know. Maybe not.
That's the question. Will they get the spot? Nobody knows.
Will they get the spot?
Nobody knows. Way,
you know, I'm gonna be honest with you here. This might sound a bit. I don't know. I'm just gonna say it. I think orcs like ITB should not be in Team DL. Even though they're maybe a great orc for Trickmania, I think we need to have 8 tier 1 orcs. They are not tier 1 orc, and they would say the same. They are not a tier 1 orc. We should have 8 tier 1 orcs in TMGL. They are an awesome orc. If they somehow fight themselves into TMGL, fair enough. But we need 8 tier 1 orcs for the sake of players.
Would be good.
8 tier 1 orcs. Edelweiss, yeah, look what happened to Edelweiss. We need 8 tier 1 orcs.
I mean, how many do we
like
have right
now?
Like
tier 2, tier 1. 3? You know, we need tier 2, tier 1. Yeah. You can always argue if something is tier 1 or not. We need 8 high class orcs. And those names are BDS, Alliance, Solary, Kameto, Big.
No.
Yeah, I think that's the tier 1.
The main
tier 1, tier 2, whatever you want to call it. People are very picky when it comes to that. You know, you want something like Liquid, Cloud9, I don't fucking know, T2,
Face.
You want Vitality.
There are many big orcs.
And there are orcs that are interested outside of TMGL that are tier 1. So, and that also contacted some players already before this change.
Mm-hmm.
So it's possible that we're gonna have 8 tier 1 orcs, and that's what you want. Like, it's just that ITB was now the example. Like, you don't want lower tier orcs.
Yep.
I trust Spando. Yeah,
does the Countess tier 1 orc?
Yeah, not really probably. Tier 1, but yeah, they bring really good exposure.
Yeah.
They would bring really, really good exposure.
Secondly, if they could get in, they could also just pick 2 random German players or something. it's so weird. Like, you could discuss weeks about this. Which orc could get in? Who would they pick? Yeah. Why would they pick them? It's like, there will be a month of speculation going on.
I really think, like, for me as a player, I would love to see an orc like, okay, look, this is just because ITB is now the example. Not to shame on ITB, but ITB is a really good orc by the looks of it. They pick up Lars, Elkon, Mime. Am I missing someone?
No.
I think those are the names.
I mean, Forever as manager, but...
Forever as manager. They literally have 4 Trickmania people in their orc picked up. Like, yeah. They invest so much. This for me is a really good challenger orc, and they can fight their way into TMGL. And this is how it should be. That orc pressuring the tier 1 orcs. And eventually they can become maybe a tier 1 orc. Because, I don't know, TMGL will be huge. I mean, it is already quite huge, to be honest. It's a W if you play in TMGL.
Yeah, definitely. Like, viewership, 70k viewers per step or something, or okay, maybe 60 or something. It's also maybe comes to another point, which is also not mentioned at all, if it will have a sponsor. And once again, us players, we have no fucking clue. We, of course, preach for it like madmans, but we will see. That's still...
So far, we don't see anything, so I would say no.
Yeah, otherwise, we've probably said that. So, Kubra is a good step into the right direction. Like, it's just, like, really good to see... How, I mean, in this case, I mean, car manufacturers are such a good example of companies that can work with Trackmania. Of course, that was not like TMGL work now, but that's still good to see some orcs getting into the game for whatever. Like, even if it's for only building track of the days, like, it's a start. Also, a question by Koons again. Will there be more players from other regions, so for example, America and Asia, in TMGL/World Cup, or at least will they put more effort in these regions as well? I mean, since they announced the regional tournaments, and you have like the... Where does it say the different regions?
We'll have the answer quickly if you want.
Yeah, go.
So this is regional tournaments, and there will be a guaranteed spot for those 3 that they listed. I think it's North America, it's Asia, and it's Middle East. So you have like three spots or four spots that are guaranteed in the World Championship Wildcard Tournament that was announced. And from the World Cup Tournament, you can qualify for the World Cup Finals, quote unquote. So you have eight spots, so 16 players, like it always has been the World Cup, and additional eight slots, which are decided in the Wildcard event. And in the World Cup Wildcard event, there are the regional players playing. So you can be scouted in those sort of World Cup Wildcard tournaments. And since there are eight additional slots, so 16 more players can qualify for the World Cup this time, there's a pretty good chance that an Asian team, whatever, can qualify to the World Cup.
Yeah.
So that's how it works. Hope that makes sense. It's a lot of information, but I think that makes sense.
Also,
there's a thing missing here in this picture, I would say.
Which one?
The wild card should be in the picture, to be fair.
Yeah.
Because the World Championship is divided by wild card and actual World Championship.
Exactly. So you can get in by immediately being like in the top 8 teams that got the most points through matchmaking, regional, and especially, of course, Grand League and Challenger. Like, that will, of course, if you do really, really sick, and like if you win a Trackmania Grand League, you will pretty much, we don't know the format or like the point system or the distribution, but you will probably be safe in the World Cup, of course. But yeah, the other way is, of course, the wild card, and that's going to be important. That's for sure.
Basically, the TMGL orgs or 16 players are basically in World Cup. Like,
yeah.
They're basically.
It would be weird if not. Let's put it that way. And also, like those regional tournaments, those that are the part of the club exist since the beginning of the game. So no, at the beginning of the game, they announced something called Nations League for the game, but that's something different. Like, don't think that's what they meant. I don't think when they released the game, I mean, maybe, but I don't think they had the plan already of doing like 2v2 format for TMGL at some point. I doubt that. But it's something different. I guess if you have more questions, then just put them in our chat. Best time to ask them now. At least we can try to answer without spoiling too much.
Contradings is coming as well. Yeah, like this is what we knew now for, you know, a month or two already. Two months.
Yep.
That there will be the console release. There will be the, you know, the world tour, quote unquote. Roughly like that. Sounds all pretty cool, you know, especially for new players.
Yeah, like also, like true, with the console release, we didn't even mention that yet. That will, of course, also hopefully give a big push to the player, and with it all released at the same time, I mean, all of the console Andes will also hopefully play matchmaking and stuff. So that could be a really, really, really big push for Trackmania, if it works out. Yeah. It could be, but we will see.
You don't know any orcs that are in yet. I mean, I'm gonna be honest with you, it's quite obvious that someone like Big Solary or Kamito are in.
Yeah. Like, it's, we don't know, but why would they kick them?
Know. Like, we actually don't know, but why would they not accept them? Why would they not want? Well, maybe they don't want because they don't want to pay two players. That obviously, you know.
Possible, yeah.
That's the only thing, but they got asked, so I doubt they're leaving. For me, those are the three orcs that are safe. I don't know about BDS. Like, BDS is a huge orc, so I'm sure... Sure, they were
silly. Yeah. But
those are
maybe
the
at
three
most.
To four names.
There
yeah,
are
those are
like
the four names.
Or, yeah, there are like 10 to 12 more where we have no idea what the hell is going to happen with them. We're going to see.
Yeah. And small orcs should be out, I guess.
Yeah.
But we don't know, you know. There's some orcs that could be in, you know, not in. We don't know. But those are like the orcs that I would say.
True.
All right.
Do we like the new format as players? I mean, from what I know, all players like it. I mean, in case it happens,
yeah,
one of the qualified players for TMGL might not play. He will probably not be the biggest fan of it. But overall, the format is really good. And I think like all of the TMGL players agree with that. From what I have heard.
I haven't seen a negative. I mean, obviously there are some concerns. When this came out, I said, if nothing changes for me in my org, we can do it. And also for me as a player, and nothing is changing, I have that guaranteed, so I said yes. And this is basically what everyone wanted, I think. People don't want to now have even less prize money than before, for example, or whatever.
True.
or not be able to go to certain lands because we have two players now, all that kind of stuff. You know, if that is cleared up with your orc or with Nadeo, then everything's fine.
Exactly. Also, question, with a best of seven, how long is a full match estimated to take? Yeah, is that a spoiler?
1 hour.
Yeah, 1 hour is the goal. If that will work out like this, I don't know. They will maybe have to do some test matches. But if it's only ties, for example, we're gonna have 10 rounds per map. And then at most, we might have 7 maps. That would be longer than an hour then. So
that's why the 10 points is still subject to potentially change, like point limit.
Exactly.
But I really think it should be 10. I don't know. I need to see a match. I need to make calculations. 10 seems to be almost very, very small amount to win a map.
Yeah, I mean, it could be, could ace 3 rounds and you're pretty much through.
Yeah, like, to be honest, you ace 2 rounds and then you just don't troll and you win.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's not that interesting to me, in my opinion. It could be pretty boring to watch. Let's say map 1, it's literally 6-0 after 2 rounds. You're just gonna tap out, maybe, and not watch because you're like, okay, let's wait for next map.
Yep.
The next 2 rounds, they are just going to win somehow. Doesn't matter if it's going to be 10-8, 10-7, 10-6. They're going to win anyways.
Okay, got another question. Besides the pro scene, will there also be some involvement with influencers or other genre streamers or something for increased viewership / popularity? No clue. Honestly, no idea. I mean, it will automatically come by just like if Virgil, for example, even like, we don't know if he will be involved with casting again or something. But even if he already plays matchmaking, people will ask, oh yeah, what is this map like? And then he will say, oh yeah, from the World Tour, and suck. And maybe they will also like pay other streamers to like showcase it or something. Would be cool, but I don't know if I would really expect that. Because that's like, yeah, I don't know, some advanced marketing in Nadeo. We will see. It would be cool.
Would one orc agree to pay 2 players at that point? I mean, if there's 8 orcs. 2 players each. They pay 2 players.
Yeah, true. I mean, if you mean if like orcs think that it's worth it for them to like have 2 players. I mean, overall, technically, with the viewership the Trackmania Grand League has at this point, which always was like, yeah, I don't know, like 50k or so. Of course, a lot of that came from single streamers, but still, overall, it's a lot of viewers. Considering that, with the approximate salary people get, I don't think the costs are too high for orcs. I would highly doubt that. Of course, for the smaller orcs, but I don't know.
I'm gonna be honest, this is why I like this so much. I think this is why Trackmania salaries are also low. Not because of the prize money only, just because there's no competition between each other. And this will probably catapult the competition. Like, if you are a certain orc that has a spot and you want to keep the spot, you want to win, you want your orc to look good, right? So you're gonna pay maybe, you know, a bit more than before just to have your player, right? Motivated or happy, or maybe even get a better player. You know, like you have it in other esports games, there will be competitions because the team name will be in front. And that is very important for... Also, maybe you guys chat if anyone wants to, you know. Oh, pro, quote-unquote, one day. It's really good for players, this change.
It's also
might
just
not look like it, but if you think about it...
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
It's also just the amount of orcs. Like, instead of having 16 orcs, we now have 8. That's already increasing the competition by a lot. Because being one of the 16 orcs, you didn't have to be, like, a great orc. Like, a super big orc, you know? Like, we had some... Pretty
yeah,
small
you just need to have a streamer, basically, and that's it.
Yeah, that was pretty much the only thing they had to have.
You pay
but
a
now,
few bucks.
Top 8, you have to have good. You have to have 2 players, and you have to like also do other stuff.
Challenge are also in teams, right? Yeah, that's the whole point. Like this is how the ecosystem should be, and this is really awesome. I really hope this is gonna work out, or they're just gonna. I really hope this is what it's gonna be, which looks like it. You have 8 good orcs in. Can be tier 1, tier 2, tier 3 in Challenger. And then you have 8 tier 1 orcs in Grand League. Well, they wanted to call it Elite or Legends, but for some reason it's not saying that anymore.
Yeah,
so I don't know.
I don't know why they changed it.
Right now we are Challenger and then we are Grand League. And with the grand players then, I guess, whatever. Like, you want the competition between each other, you know what I mean? And then you want to be, if you are a challenger player, this is also a great thing. You're a challenger player and you're literally carrying the ass of your teammate. You could literally be picked up by an orc middle of the year. They say, yo, we bench Massa and we take this guy from China. And literally what could happen?
Yeah. I could also even, technically could
this
also
is how it
even happen.
Be, you know?
That could also even happen, like when you play the regional tournaments, like maybe not the ones of the less, like the regions like I don't know like Asia or so, which is not played by that many people. But if you do, if we have like the EU one, and you do really really good there against the pros, even then the orc could pick you up if you like. You can really show off in a lot of cases, or if you dominate matchmaking 24/7. I don't know if the orc will pick you up because of that, but technically it could happen.
Yeah, it'll be wild if you against Peck and Carl matchmaking. Yeah, will most likely happen. Will most likely happen such matchups.
No, I mean, if it will be 2v2 and then yeah, the two teammates decide to practice together. I mean, it's also a good way. Like, it's also the new matchmaking will be a good way to like practice the consistency and stuff for us TMGL players.
You know, also, it like, will not be boring matches anymore when you watch Granati play Launchpad practice. Because you will be like, oh my god, what is he doing there? What is he doing there? Is he gonna queue matchmaking now? Oh my god, let's play matchmaking as well. You know, it's like everything's like batches together, you know?
Exactly. Like,
because you have to play Launchpad as well if you wanna play matchmaking on highest level.
Yep.
Which will be the goal, you know? There will be now, this is what I always meant. There needs to be incentive to play the game. Now everyone has a goal. Doesn't matter if you're casual or not. Even if you're casual, you're gonna be like, oh, I want to play against these guys. Doesn't matter if you want to go pro or not. If you want to stay casual, no problem. But your goal will still be to get a high rank in this game.
No.
Even doesn't matter what your skill level is. You will be like, I want to reach that. That should be, now everyone has a goal. Before that, there was no goal. Now there will be a goal. A goal in this game.
True, which is really important. So, and I mean, most players, I mean, of course, people are, there are also people just purely playing for fun, but most people that play games also want to, like, be good at it or prove themselves once in a while. At least I would argue that. And I mean, in which game can you directly play against a pro player? Like, if you take CSGO matchmaking, you, of course, also have the ranks. You want to, at some point, you want to be, like, global elite if you do really good. I mean, technically, you can meet the pros there if they also decide to play, but you know what I mean. Like, it's really cool.
That's a good question. But so MM will finally move away from campaign maps, right? Well, what we know, what we got told, is campaign maps for noobs, like very beginners. And then when you have a certain rank, which says in this news post, you get simplified TMGL maps. And when you are like one of the highest ranks, you play actual TMGL maps. And can collect points for the World Tour, I think. That's now, I think. But this is how the steps are. First, easy maps for noobs, then simplified TMGL maps for average, I guess, players, and then for better players or good players or pro players, the real maps. So that's probably going to depend on your rank.
Yep, which just makes sense. You cannot give a bronze player a regular TMGL map. He would rage quit. even we rage quit sometimes. So
yeah, exactly.
Will it be less stressful for the players now? I mean, I don't know, we will see how the format will be exactly and how the schedule will be. We have like the three main events.
I think it's gonna be more enjoyable to practice and prepare.
Yeah, definitely.
And live life. But I think matches are gonna be more stressful. And near end of seasons, it's gonna be actually more stressful. Just because you need to perform in every match.
Yeah.
Like, there is no more one bad step, because it would suck if you have a bad step and your teammate has a good step, but you lose because of you.
Yeah.
So there will be...
But there will also be pushing. Like, sorry to interrupt, but there will also be pushing. Like, do you want to improve that?
But you know how it's going to go. The thing is, about Trickmania, it will be all about times. People don't care. Let's say we play together. People won't care if I build all the practice maps or if I did the most training, if I showed you 5 lines. Or if I motivated you in the match or whatever, it doesn't matter. Only thing that counts is Massa collected, I don't know, 9 out of 20 points in that match, while Granati had like 18 out of 20. I don't know. and then we lose. That's all it counts. It will be stats. Just an example. So I think that will be quite rough as a player.
Yeah. There might also be like, that's also a good thing, like about which players the orcs are gonna pick, because it might also be important to pick players that have like a good synergy. So if you throw one player in and then another one, and they for some reason hate each other, although that's not really the case, because like all TMGL players are super nice and they get along nicely, mostly.
Yeah, but you will see. You know, like, it's gonna change, maybe. Yeah, you know, yeah. You don't know.
And that's also why it's not gonna work if you put Carl Jr. and then like some random Bronx Andy. Although that's not gonna happen. It's an extreme example, of course, but technically it could be possible. But it probably won't be teams with a huge skill gap. So, because otherwise, yeah, it just wouldn't work out.
Yep.
Do you guys think that prize money is actually worth training and playing for a whole long season? Or divided over the different levels or something? I mean, we don't know the prize money yet. That's the thing. We will see. We also don't know if there's going to be a sponsor. So that's about to see. But in general, if Trackmania doesn't really do the biggest step ever now, I don't think the prize money will like go like 10x for for the next year. So for the amount of time you have to put in to be a professional Trackmania player, it's just, it's rough. It's rough, honestly.
The motivation is the salary, not the prize money.
Yep, definitely.
That's always about in Trackmania. Yeah. And it always has been the past 2 years. Yeah.
Like, unless you win, you're going to earn more from your salary. Even if you have, like, very low salary. That's the thing. Wait, come off the lane for a minute.
You want the salary.
So. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I think we are done now, right?
Yeah, for the most part. If you still have questions, you can probably still discuss on our Discords a little bit here and then. At least on mine, and yours as well, I guess. And if, I mean, there's going to be a lot of discussion. You will find a lot of stuff on Discords, on Reddit probably as well. So there's going to be a lot of speculations about the maps as well. But I hope you all understood what it's about so far. I think we managed to explain it somewhat nicely. I hope so, at least. But yeah, if there's still some cluelessness, we are open for questions, of course. But yeah, definitely looking forward to that. Like, to the whole next year. Gonna be nice. And you are.
Yeah. Make sure to hype this up.
Definitely.
And be positive, quote unquote. But it looks pretty damn positive on the social so far. So, that's nice.
Cool.
Okay. All right, I'll go piss off. Good luck in holiday.
Yo, thank you. See ya.